Howdy, y'all. I don't know if you can tell, but it's pretty early here in the armpit of America. On this early morning of, I believe it's, what is it? It's Thursday, February 2nd. I have an old pair of muckers that I've used for a while, and basically what's going on with them, I think that's the one that has the hole in it. So yeah, we gotta fix it. So that's what I'm gonna do. Hey, skirt! Skirt! Come here, you bastard! Sorry about that, I saw a cat. So what we're gonna do to these things is basically, I'm gonna use this rag, I'm gonna wipe all the shit off of them. Then I'm going to take this Flex Seal, as seen on TV, and I'm going to spray a very liberal coating all over the side of it to hopefully fix the hole. I had them on the wrong side. I mean, it's all dried off or it just froze. I don't know which one. It's like 20 degrees, but that's what the plan is. Oh, hold on. Let me move it up here on the white part of my truck bed so y'all can see it. Yep. Looks pretty good. Just gonna go ahead and set that down here and let it set up. Alright, we're down here in the workshop now. There's some trailer wiring for something y'all see a little down the road. But yeah, it looks like the Flex Seal job is gonna hold pretty well if I just let her sit here for a while. I'm gonna put a pretty good coating on there this time, other than last time, because I just gave a little spray last time, but looks like this time it's gonna hold a lot better than it did. So, yeah. Well, as you can see, this is gonna be the end result. I mean, yeah, they're pretty old, but I think it's been about 8 hours since I sprayed it on there this morning. And it looks pretty good. I mean, it's a lot better than spending $100 on a new pair. So the other guy who operates this channel made a video of his rod and reel arsenal. So I think I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing. But before we do that, I got to show you that I'm not a total fishing nerd. I'm looking to get an ugly stick rod for my Zepco 404, but I mean, we'll see how that goes. I mean, we'll probably video it when we go and buy it. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at my rod and reel arsenal. All right, first off, we got the Zepco 404 here, and this is truly an American staple. I mean, it's just so simple. All you got to do is click the button and cast it. Nothing more than that. And up next here, we just got the basic Shakespeare Walmart spinner. I mean, it's fun to hit the pond with this, you know. I've caught a few bass on here. I mean, I'm the type of person that will just like break a rod like every time I go fishing. But yeah, as you can see, we got the we get a chartreuse Senko on here. And let me go ahead and just say, yeah, that is a Senko.
And like I said before, being that I break a rod just about every time I go fishing, this is why I use crappy Walmart rods.
For example, like on the 404, we just have a basic Shakespeare rod from Walmart. It's called the Durango. That's not really the name that I would have picked for it, but I mean, you get it caught in a tree, you can just snap it off and not worry about it. So yeah, that's why I buy $9 rods.
Anyway, thanks for watching. I believe our channel's hit about 10 subs, and that's pretty cool. So thanks. Bye.